Sean Spicer is Communications Director for the Republican National Committee. Sean, thank you very much for being here. So we just spoke with the mayor. He doesn't think this is going to be necessary. They're now saying the storm is likely to track a little farther west and may not be a direct hit on Tampa. Can't say for sure right now. You're going to get rain, that's for sure. You're going to get wind. But let's just talk about your worst-case scenario plans. What happens if it's a direct hit? Can you still have this convention?
Absolutely. Obviously, we're tracking the storm. We've got contingency plans in place. We're concerned about the safety of the folks that are traveling here and the residents, but this convention will go on. One way or another, we've got those plans in place to tell the story of Mitt Romney, why he needs to take over this country, be the comeback team with Paul Ryan, and get this economy moving again. So we're ready to go. We've got a ton of plans, and while we're focused on or tracking that storm, we're really excited about those 4 days coming up that we will be able to talk about where this country can head
right.
And what Paul Ryan and Mitt Romney will do.
How many, you have what, some 50,000 people coming to town for this thing between the press and the delegates and so on. If you needed to, I mean, so folks have been talking about could they reschedule this thing? I mean, is this something that could be moved after tens of millions of dollars invested and 50,000 people en route to Tampa?
Well, the number one priority of a convention is to give the official nomination to the team, Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan. We've got the ability to do that. As I mentioned, we've got the contingency plans in place.
But you keep saying you have them. But what are they?
We're not going to get into those kind of details, Megan. I mean, in the sense that it depends. I mean, we're tracking the storm as it develops. We look at the options that are available to us. But, you know, as the mayor said, the plans are there both logistically and operationally. Our goal is to make sure that we put on the best convention possible. And as the weather updates come in, we'll make those adjustments. But right now, everything is focused on putting on 4 days of talking about Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan and why Barack Obama is taking
right.
this country in the wrong direction.
What do you make of it? Because I remember 4 years ago, we were sitting in St. Paul, and Hurricane Gustav hit down along the same, it was the Gulf Coast. And we were watching
yep.
that. We had to take a day off. You guys put the convention on hold for a day. We lost, I think, Monday of our coverage. And now here we go again, only this time it's the actual city in which the Republican National Convention is being held. What do you make of it?
Well, what I make of it is that, again, in that case, what they did is they said, hey, the lives and the safety and the well-being of the people along the Gulf was the paramount issue, and so the convention made a decision that said, hey, we need to focus on those people who are hurting. Again, as we look each day as we get more information and look ahead, we'll make those kind of decisions as are necessary. Right now, we're tracking it. It looks like we should be fine.
Yeah.
If it takes a turn, and we need to, we'll make those adjustments. But again, we've got a great team. We've got a great partner in the city of Tampa. The Governor Rick Scott has been working hand in hand with our team. The National Weather Service and NOAA have been keeping us up to date, you know, on a almost an hourly basis. So we're tracking everything. We've got great partners in this city, in this state,
right.
and at the federal level. So I feel really good about who we're working with, the information that we're getting, and our plans to move forward.
Well, I feel for you, Sean, because I know you put a lot of time and planning into this convention. Of course, you want to see it go off without a hitch. Hopefully, the weather forecast will work in your favor. And listen, at a minimum, here's what you have going for you. People tend to watch TV when a hurricane is coming near the United States, and so maybe you'll get a few more eyeballs for your big convention.
Well, all the news crews are here, so we know we've got the ability to do that. And I'll tell you, the number of people that are coming to this convention is record levels for us. The excitement that we have for this ticket and to see something historic is just something we've never seen in the history of the RNC. So we really want to give the people both here in Tampa and throughout the country that get to watch it on Fox the best experience possible.
All right, Sean. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Meg.